Okay, here we go. We got a mandatory aim mission. Now, this ain't too bad. You know, you just go around the town destroying robots, supposedly protecting Elise from them. Now, this part of the game is pretty much pointless because I think after this they just part ways and then she suddenly gets captured again and Sonic doesn't even know about this whole time as she was captured again. So I guess they just needed to have a bit more Amy in the game to increase the length of Silver's story, so they did this. It's just making it take longer to get to the last story. I should turn invisible. They can't see me now. But they can still hurt me. Oh, you see that? Because I was already in an attacking animation, she didn't do her I'm turning invisible again animation. Oh yeah, and the guy's gone. It's just this now. Yeah, the guy had a heart attack and they replaced him with that. And that was the whole thing. So we got more Amy gameplay, hooray! We really didn't need that. So what happens now? What happens? Are we back to Silver? Oh yeah, check this out. I couldn't remember if this was in a cutscene or something, but I guess it is. When she gets kidnapped again. We should have been counting how many times she's been kidnapped. It's gotta be like 5. She gets kidnapped more times in this game than Princess Peach has been kidnapped. Well, I'm exaggerating, but you know, she gets kidnapped a lot in one game. Oh my god, it's that really shady guy who helped us earlier.
Tell me, who is the endless trigger?
Mephiles, I'm having second thoughts.
Why does he want to destroy the world?
Why does that matter to you?
He's got an awesome voice.
Unless you complete your task, your future will remain the same.
Okay, we're getting really close to where I was before now, in the original playthrough. So we will need to find a new ability for this. And then we have what was probably the funniest moment for me in Nerdcube's playthrough of this. It was ridiculous. I highly recommend watching that. And Tale of Grace's playthrough, they're both extremely funny. Alright, so over here is the vending machine. It's a vending machine for skills and abilities and whatnot. And little gems that Sonic puts in his shoes. Alright, so we need Heart of Wind, which makes us do this. Yeah, it doesn't help that much. The game doesn't let us do the next part without doing this, but we can actually do the next part without even using it once. And I don't like it because it takes up your gauge down there. So before long it's all just gone. Yeah, but this is what we have to do here is we have to be really stealthy and sneak into the station. So, yeah, we just gotta do that. See, we're supposed to hide behind these, but the thing is, they can actually see you when you're behind those. Oh, I just did that in 50 seconds, by the way. So, they can see you if you hide behind there for some reason, and they can also walk through them. Yeah, it's actually quite ridiculous. But you just saw me do that in 15 seconds, because if they're not looking directly at you, then you can just walk right by. You know, it's actually pretty easy. But really annoying if you get caught, because then you gotta go through the loading screens. And then you gotta try again. But anyway, here we are. Radical Train. It's radical! God, this is one of my favorite stages in the game. Radical Train. Everyone's Radical Train. They all have a good Radical Train. God, I don't know why I like this stage so much. I just really do. Ooh. Could have fallen off there. Right, so this actually feels kind of fast paced for Silver, actually. But, okay, here's the thing. Do you guys think that Sonic and Silver weigh about the same size? Weigh about the same much, maybe? You know, the same amount of weight? Well, Silver by himself doesn't tip the scales here at all, whereas Sonic does all by himself. So I guess Silver's just really light, even though he looks like he'd weigh about the same amount as Sonic. Whatever. Let's just do this. Yeah. So, unlike Sonic, we are not racing a train, we are just going through a level, you know, less pressure for us this time. Yeah, let's break down the door by throwing stuff at it. Alright, you, help me break down the door, please. There we go. Something had to break it eventually. Oh yeah, I just got all of them in one. That was good. Oh, there's a box in here. That shouldn't be there. Oh, yeah. Yeah, there we go. I can't grab lasers with my second pieces. It looks like I can only avoid them. Well then, let's avoid the lasers. So yeah, that was basically the same as Sonic's, but a lot slower. And this level is pretty good as Silver, actually. I still find it quite fun. See, I give this game a lot of crap for being bad, but I enjoy playing the game. I find it fun. Also, Silver can't grind. I don't like it when a character can't grind. Well, you know, normally it's not that bad, but hedgehogs can normally grind. Sonic and Shadow could grind. Amy could grind in Sonic Adventure 2. And in and everyone could grind in the advanced games, you know. But in this 3D game, Silver the Hedgehog cannot grind, even though Shadow and Silver can. And Blaze can grind as well. I think there was grinding in Sonic Rivals, which had Silver in. Did Sonic Rivals have grinding? I can't remember it very well, but if they did, then Silver would have grinded in that. Come on, just break it down already. There we go. Oh yeah, this is where Silver's session ends. And we get straight to the boss battle. Alright, so at the end of this part, we should be where I was in the original playthrough, which means we are going to be officially ahead, which is excellent. New territory for the channel. Yeah, this just isn't Sonic's day. He's fighting Silver and he's losing Elise. This is actually one of my favourite parts of the game. Not much the fight, but the cutscene that happens after. Father, I will not allow you to give 18 to sell. You will not become perfect on my watch. Whoa, I just got sniped. Goddamn, Shadow. Calm down, man. Chaos Spear. Yeah, Shadow is a lot more dangerous than Sonic. But it's still basically the same thing. What he likes to do is use Chaos Spear to snipe you. And then while you're stunned, he'll home attack you, and then he'll breakdance. And if you just keep running, then you'll always be able to get away from the breakdance. You can even do it without stunning you. One thing you can do is jump up here, and he won't be able to get to you unless he's already up here. See, he just can't do it. He's not good enough. Right, I need to. Oh, he got me. I need to get some rings. Am I dead? No, I'm not dead. Oh my god, Shadow, can you just not? I need to get some rings. Come on. Yeah, I got some rings. Alright, I don't think he'll jump over there either. No, so he's just running, and now he's being dragged away by the tomb. Where is he? Oh god, there he is. Yeah. Oh god, he's angry. He's using the Kaioken. I know that's the wrong character, but that's what it looks like, you know? It looks like Goku's Kaioken. So, in this canon, Vegeta learned the Kaioken. Where is he? Oh, he's on the train! Come on, he's almost dead. So close. Yeah, I win. And now, my favorite cutscene in the game.
That was easy.
And that's why I like this cutscene, because we get to get Silver take a boost to the back of the head.
You don't bother. Chaos Emerald's power. I control time and space. You can't break free.
I won't give up. It all depends on me. Can't lose. Not when I'm so close.
So what were they trying to do? Just go super fast there with Chaos Control? And see who can land the first punch? That fiend! How could he do that? People played this game 10 years ago. Yeah, that's the thing that happened. I don't know why this looks so good, because it's clearly not CGI, but it looks a lot better than the rest of the game. I don't know what's up with that.
Why, Silver? Why do you refuse to listen to my voice? At least.
Big boom, we better go see what that's all about. Look, this is where we were in Sonic's story when we time traveled. This is where Eggman's been hanging out. It's all coming together. Oh yeah, the old guy seems pretty still. He might be dead.
Plane.
Whatever you say, old man. I'll seal it with this thing you just gave me. Alright, what time are we on for this? So 21 minutes. I guess I'll do the Sage, you know? We shall surpass my original playthrough of this game in this part. I mean, this stage is only going to take like 10 minutes anyway, so I might as well do it. Right, we should also see some... Yep, we're going to see some Shadow gameplay. So, Shadow plays more like Sonic. You know, does he... No, he doesn't have a spin dash. But he can bait dance. And he has a homing attack. But Shadow can do this with his homing attack. Yeah, he can chain it into regular attacks, which is pretty cool. I mean, you never use the Brave Dancer move, but you'll use that other move a lot. Because it really helps in taking down the guys that have multiple bars of health. So, the big guys and the worm guys. It's like a super effective move. And one other thing Shadow can do is drive vehicles. Yeah, he can drive motorbikes and cars. You know, it's pretty cool, except they don't handle great. Especially the watercraft.
There's no strength in numbers.
There's only strength in hedgehogs.
Shadow, I'll be looking out for the truth.
I don't trust you yet, Father. I think this is the part where Silver Sori starts to get really good. And Shadow Sori gets I think by this point Shadow Sori is already quite good, but it just gets better from this point. You know, in terms of gameplay, Sonic Sori is probably the best. Because you play as Sonic a lot and he's the most well-rounded character in the game. If you don't count plays, you don't play as plays a lot anyway. But in terms of story, I think Shadow's episode is the best. And I'm not counting the final episode, the last episode, because it's, you know, it's the last episode. I'd probably just jump over there. Well, let's just do this normally. No, you're supposed to get stunned. Yeah, like that. All right, here we go. Some platforming, some good old platforming, because remember this game is a platformer. So we gotta have some of that. Well, that boss had quite the trip. Come on, get stunned. Oh, I'm holding something. Come on. Come on. There we go. Now this guy can die. Ooh, switch. I wonder what this does. It opens the door. Right, now where do we go? Oh, one up. I'll take that. Do we go up here? No, we do not. Ah, now where do we go? This level always confuses me. I never know what to do when we get back to this room. Do we go this way? Yes, we do. We do go this way. God, I think this is the same room, but at the same time it might not be the same room. I don't know. But yeah, we got this again. Remember we did this as Sonic? Wasn't that fun? It wasn't. Oh no. Right, just don't hit the lasers and we won't die. Oh, go fast. Now go slow. Now go fast. Alright. God, I love this shock bracelet thing. It's so helpful. Rid of the god enemies. Oh, there's another enemy. Oh, there's a god in this door. Did not even see this door. Loading, loading, loading. It's loading, loading, loading. What is it loading? It's loading this. Wasn't this like the end of Sonic's part of the level? Like, well, it seems like they're going through different parts of the level actually. Because Sonic had parts in a different part of the level. This kind of looks like the end of his, except it was all red. Come on, get stunned. Ooh, one up. Always want to get them one ups. Oh, another ball. Slow down, Silver. Whoa, 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 whoa. Damn it! Can I make it? No, I can't make it. What? Just destroyed the ball. I don't think I hit any of the lasers. Anyway, let's try this again. You can actually do this without the ball, but I'm gonna see if I can do this with the ball. Never mind, it's been destroyed. Guess I'm doing it without the ball. Oh crap, I'm doomed. Alright, try again. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Ugh, okay. I got this. No problem. Tis but a scratch. It would appear so, Silver. That's very vigilant of you to notice that. Look, it's Echo the Dolphin. He's in this game. Alright. Oh, another one up. I'll take that. You cannot keep me from my one-ups. We will always find a way to be together. Let's use magnets to kill them. Ooh. Eggman probably should have put a few more lasers in there. Then I wouldn't have been able to jump straight through it. Okay, this has got to be the end of Silver's part of the level. And it is. Excellent, and that took less than 10 minutes. Just about 10 minutes. Let's say it took 10 minutes.
Looks like I'm on a roll.
I'm on a roll. And now we get to find out what happens after this, which we did not get to find out in the original playthrough. Because we have finally gotten past that. 4 years it took, but we're finally here. Do you have some trouble there, Silver?
Hey, what are you doing? You've got to leave.
I have my duty. This living flame has been entrusted to the royal family.
This living flame is a monster, sir. Sure, this seems safe. Yeah, bring little girl in here. Where there's a flaming monster.
The living flame that has been entrusted to the royal family. Fall into slumber with a royal soul.
No, you look like you're dying. You probably shouldn't be carrying her, because you might drop her.
I'm sorry, but can you take her to a safe place?
Sure, why not? I'll do that. So Elise hasn't cried for at least 10 years. So, which means even after she found out that she no longer has any parents, she did not cry. That is incredible. Either she's really good at holding back her tears, or she just hated her father for some reason. And how does someone not cry for 10 years? I mean, she didn't like smack her face on something really hard.
Did you do it?
Yes.
And end up crying from it. Have you ever stepped on Legos? They hurt. She never stepped on Lego after this. So, if she cries, then it's the end of the world. And she better not cry then. No one upset her.
You're going to leave it behind?
Yes. I already know what becomes of it in the future. It's time to return.
It's time to go home.
Yes.
It's time for Shadow to go home. Silver can't do that yet. He's not done in the past. Or present. It's the present for Sonic and Shadow, but it's the past for Silver. Oh, that's something that's just split up. All three characters are like their own timelines. Like, if you know Shadow's story, he's kind of the hedgehog of the past, Sonic's always been the present, and Silver is clearly the hedgehog of the future. So they each have their own timelines, even though Shadow is from the present. We're back.
Please. What did you see?
Wait, how does she know I've been to the past of the past?
Wasn't Sonic the Hedgehog.
She wasn't even there. For all she knows, I could have teleported.
They're quite noisy.
Yes, I heard that the princess here left for Dr. Eggman's base. In response to his earlier threat.
What if his ultimate objective was to release Iblis?
We can't let that happen. We have to save the princess. I've played through almost the entire Silver episode in one day. That's good. That is good. I have a lot of editing to do.
I'm going to stop Dr. Eggman no matter what. Please, let's go after him.
Yes, but let's do that another day. Because I am done and I've been at this for like 3 hours or something. I don't know, however long it took for me to get to this part. So, save, finish it. And that would be all for now.